Here's my favorite metaphor to help UX professionals apply generative AI tools to their design and research work. Think about working with AI tools like you'd work with an intern. In our field, we sometimes use a persona to represent a group of people as an imaginary individual. So let's do that for AI in a UX context. Meet Ari, your new AI-based UX intern. Ari represents the current crop of generative AI tools like ChatGPT, Claude, and Gemini. For best results, we need to give Ari clear guidance and oversight. By setting appropriate expectations and following best practices, you can benefit from Ari's potential while avoiding pitfalls. Our imaginary AI intern is incredibly smart. On paper, they're way overqualified to be an intern. They have vast knowledge spanning just about every discipline. So if you want a lecture on gestalt principles, color theory, or the history of wireframes, Ari's got you covered, because Ari knows a lot about a lot of things. Plus, they're extremely efficient and able to complete complex tasks in seconds. But book smarts and speed don't always equal UX skills. So let's talk about Ari's limitations. Ari lacks true empathy and emotional intelligence. They can sometimes miss context and nuance that humans pick up on intuitively, and they can't tell if the information that they're giving you is accurate or just plausible-sounding fluff. So, while Ari is a prodigy at ingesting and synthesizing information, they still need lots of human guidance to apply that knowledge effectively. Keep that dynamic in mind as we look at how to work with Ari. First, know that you can ask Ari for advice and guidance, but you shouldn't accept any information that you can't verify or recognize as true. Remember, Ari is your intern, not your mentor. If you're new to UX, be aware that it'll be harder for you to catch Ari's mistakes and incorrect advice. For example, you can ask Ari to conduct a design review of an interface, but set your expectations appropriately. Know that Ari will miss some issues, misinterpret elements, and propose some fairly obvious changes. Ari works best with specific, detailed instructions. Like many interns, Ari needs focused projects and does best with clear step-by-step directions. Don't give Ari a big open-ended project without any guidance. For example, don't ask Ari to generate an entire research plan for you. Instead, walk Ari through each step of building a research plan. Generating the research questions, determining the method, filling in screener templates, things like that. And, like most interns or new employees, Ari probably doesn't have much context for your organization and its goals. To get good results, you need to share the relevant details about the organization, business goals, and research needs. Finally, it's important to note that while Ari can help with a lot of UX work, Ari isn't well suited to every project or need. If you've managed an intern in the past, you may have encountered situations where you spent more time helping them than you would have if you'd just done the task by yourself. That can happen often with Ari. The amount of context, instructions, and double-checking that they'll need may not always be worthwhile. Hopefully that's a helpful metaphor as you decide how to integrate AI into your UX practice. To summarize, when working with AI tools to assist in your research and design work, remember to always double-check the AI's work, think of AI tools as an intern, not a mentor, and provide ample context and specific instructions for best results.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more of our UX videos, take a look at these over here and consider subscribing to our channel. On our website, nngroup.com, you can access our free library of over 2,000 articles. You can also register for one of our UX courses that offer live, hands-on UX training.